The Criminal History of Chief Keef. Chief Keef is one of the most infamous Chicago rappers of all time. Born on the 15th of August 1995, Keith Ferrell Cozart, better known by his stage name Chief Keef, is an American rapper, singer, songwriter, and record producer. The Southside rapper burst into the scene as a high school teen, hitting the airwaves with his lyrical prowess and distinctive flow. Everyone was vibing to the young rapper's songs until things started going, well, south. Keef has been at loggerheads with the authorities for almost everything, ranging from weapon possession to drug charges. Today in this video, we will highlight the criminal history of rapper Chief Keef. But before we begin, kindly subscribe to our channel for more of our amazing weekly videos. Also, don't forget to turn on the notification button for timely updates of our new content. Let's get it on. Quite frankly, Chief Keef has more legal issues than his hit songs. After showing early promise that saw record labels battle for his signature, the rapper's career appears to have taken a steady nosedive, and time doesn't seem like a solution in his case. His run-ins with authorities started in 2011 when he was just 15 years old. On the 27th of January 2011, Chief Keef was arrested and charged with a Class X felony for manufacturing and delivering heroin. As a juvenile offender, the authorities determined him to be delinquent and allowed him to serve time under house arrest. A few months later, on the 2nd of December 2011, Chief left his grandmother's home holding a coat over his arm. He ran into police officers who were responding to a shots fired call near 61st Street and Michigan Avenue. The officers stopped him for routine questioning, but the rapper decided to drop the coat he was holding before flashing his handgun. On noticing he had messed up, Chief Keef decided to show the officers a clean pair of heels, effectively making him a suspect. The officers pursued the then 16-year-old rapper, who, after making several turns and noticed he was running out of breath, decided to turn around and point a gun at them. According to reports filed over the incident, the officers were then forced to discharge their weapons. Luckily for Keef, they missed. They later caught him and recovered a loaded pistol. The rapper was taken to court and charged with three counts of aggravated assault with a firearm on a police officer and aggravated unlawful use of a weapon. Keef was also slapped with a misdemeanor charge for resisting arrest. He was held in the Cook County Juvenile Detention, but later the judge came to his rescue and sentenced him to home confinement at his grandmother's house. Almost a year later, on the 5th of September 2012, Chicago police announced that Chief Keef was being investigated for a possible connection to the shooting of fellow rapper Joseph Coleman. The latter went by the name of Lil Jojo. The investigation was sparked by Keef himself, who took to Twitter to mock the departed soul. After sensing things were getting out of hand, the rapper claimed that his account had been hacked and that it was not him who made the post. The mother of the slain rapper maintained that Chief Keef paid hitmen to take his son out. He was later remanded at juvenile detention on the 17th of October 2012 for alleged violations of parole rules. This was in response to a video interview he had earlier held at a shooting range, which included footage of him discharging a firearm. On the 31st of December 2012, Chief Keef was yet again issued with a judicial summon for a new and unrelated parole violation. Prosecutors argued that the rapper had changed locations without alerting the relevant authorities. The hearing was set for the 2nd of January 2014. Despite the prosecutor's calls to have him jailed, the judge showed leniency to the rapper and released him, citing inadequate evidence. However, just 2 weeks later, Keef was picked up again over the video footage issue. He was sentenced to 2 months in a juvenile detention facility. He was released on the 14th of March 2013. Apart from his multiple criminal activities at that time, apparently, Keef was also busy violating agreements with his clients. On the 17th of January 2013, he was sued by a Washington, D.C.-based promotional firm, Team Major. The company wanted Keef's neck for missing a show and now demanded $75,000 in settlement. According to the firm, Chief Keef was supposed to perform at the O2 Arena in London on the 29th of December 2012, but he neither showed up nor explained to anyone where he was on the said date. As expected, Keef blatantly ignored the lawsuit and was later ordered by the court to pay a staggering $230,000 in damages to the company. On May 20th, 2013, Chief Keef was arrested in Georgia for allegedly smoking marijuana in public and causing public disorder. He was fined and released later on the same day. 8 days later, the now notorious lawbreaker was arrested for driving at a top speed of 110 miles per hour in an area with a limit of 55 miles per hour. The incident that happened in Chicago also included driving with an unlawful number of passengers. Keef was later released on bond. On the 17th of June the same year, he appeared in court and pleaded guilty of speeding. He was slapped with several conditions, including paying a fine of $531, serving 18 months of probation, completing 60 hours of community service, and undergoing random drug tests. The Chicago rapper realized his life was headed for the worst and decided to commit himself to a rehabilitation center. But just a few days after leaving the facility, he was arrested in Illinois for driving under the influence of marijuana while using a suspended license. He was also cited for having no proof of insurance. On February 4, 2014, Chief Keef was sued by Kim Productions for failing to appear at a Rap Cure benefit concert in Cleveland, Ohio. The company claimed that they had paid Keef $15,000 up front, only for him to disappear, a move that saw the whole event canceled. In June 2014, Chief Keef was evicted from his Highland Park home for failing to pay rent and other miscellaneous crimes. In January 2017, he was arrested for allegedly beating and robbing a music producer identified as Ramsey the Great. Ramsey reported the incident to the police, claiming that Chief Keef stole his Rolex watch and threatened him with a firearm. However, these charges were later dropped due to lack of sufficient evidence. In June 2017, he was arrested in South Dakota for smoking marijuana and being found in possession of other drugs. His latest encounter with the authorities was in 2019 when he pleaded no contest for the previous charge and was given a suspended sentence. From the chronology of events in the video, it's crystal clear that the Southside rapper is not a law-abiding citizen. His once promising career is gone with the winds, and no record labels wish to work with him. Let's just hope he'll get his groove back before it's too late. Did you enjoy our video? On a scale of 1 to 10, how shocked are you at the criminal history of Chief Keef? Well, if you enjoyed our video, be sure to click on the subscribe button for more of such fantastic content. Please give us a like, share the video, and don't forget to turn on the notification button. Let us know your thoughts on Chief Keef's criminal history in the comment section below.